What up? This is another ChatGPT coding session, live session, hustling with me, hustling with ChatGPT, and Mangolini, your host, Goober Studios, coming to you with some new playlist tunes we got here. You're a ghost, seeing your loved ones for the first time before going to the afterlife. Beautiful music. And today, we're about to finish our app and launch it, hopefully in the next 2 hours. So stay tuned and stay hustling. Let's go, everybody. Let's go.
All right.
You guys can see him? Yep. Sounds
good to me.
All right.
So, what if we just remove the ability to write a custom message and just have it send the results directly to the email?
Okay, and then what?
So like you'd put your name and email, and then it would send you, it'd mail you the name and email with the results at the top, scroll up.
And but what are they sending it on? Is it like submit to team type shit?
Yeah, it'd just be like submit results or submit to team or whatever. Yeah. Why do you need them to write a custom message anyway?
No, I just thought it was just more like I feel like they can like humanize it, you know. They're like saying they have a special request or something like that.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I mean, right. When you put it like that, I guess it's not necessary. I just thought it's like, why not?
Because I feel like it's one extra step for them.
Mm-hmm. Because, okay, so you don't think that for saying like, okay, here's you calculated your app, and then you want a custom quote? Like you add your custom inquiry, or should it just be, oh, you want a custom quote, submit report to be contacted by the team or something like that?
Yeah, something like that. Hold on, let me check one second. I can't hear your playlist, by the way.
You can't?
I can't, no.
Oh, okay, that's fine.
I don't think you can share it on Discord either, right?
No, I can't. Actually, there's probably a way, but I'm not sure if you want to hear my playlist.
Why not?
Oh, you didn't see output device. I don't know, it's like pretty weird music sometimes. It's usually cinematic music. I like coding to cinematic music, make it like feel like I'm in a movie. But usually it should be able to.
You think the oh yeah, you're right. You think the what's it called? The premium version of ChatGPT prints out longer code?
Yeah, I think so. I think because it won't have any disturbances during high activity.
Oh, I see. Boom, blah, blah. Got group procedures in the building.
Can you hear my shit? Hell yeah, hell yeah, hell yeah. Come on, GPT. Show me your magic, GPT. Suddenly doesn't know how to convert to HTML anymore.
Horrible.
This guy, he's so inconsistent. Where did you define interior style? Thank you.
I'm getting pretty close. Think I know this year's. Are you making any progress?
Yeah, just troubleshooting some stuff.
Code at the bottom is my code, right? The one I sent you.
Yeah.
Let's do do this.
Bro, you gotta listen to this playlist I'm listening to right now. What happened to that house music thing I gave you last time? Did it work?
Holy shit, dude, I got it.
Works for you?
Wait, hold on.
Come on, man. Why is it not?
Wait, hold on. Can't talk this shit. Goober.
Yeah.
Good. Test this out. Oh shit! Did I do it on the calculator? Oh no, man. I was working on the wrong thing.
Yeah,
don't
just. Yeah. Oh, you got rid of the submit inquiry, but then there's no email.
Yeah. No, I'll show you. Click on it. What? It just worked on my end. Oh, wait, sorry, wrong one. Disregard that.
Dungus, so many dungus.
I sent you the wrong app. Yeah.
You send it?
Hold on. I sent you the index one. I should have sent you mingled. So let's try mingled now. There you go, try this. Wait, no. Hold on. I'm still sending you the wrong one.
Yo, there's a random 2 over here.
The what? Oh, dude, I'm sending you the wrong one.
Hey, you know how you can recall the definition of this interior design selection? Is it through span?
Okay. Wait, try the mango leader now? What was your question?
So, you see this here? It's my code. I was like, here are some span interior design style ideas. And this is what it looks like here. But what I wanted to display is the selection that I chose in interior style. So it's supposed to say, here are some classic modern.
Yeah, so you'll have to define that at the bottom. So you go, scroll down. I'll show you. Scroll down. Go to like standard. Yeah, go there. You see where it says standard?
Yeah.
If standard, so at the bottom of the last code would be another code that does that. So if standard would have its own one, its other one would have its own one. Get it?
I'm doing it based on this thing, not this thing. So shouldn't it be
based on the top one? Oh, okay.
Where is it?
So basically, you see how we have the if. You see how we have the if thing? So you'll set a similar thing for, instead of if standard, if classic, if whatever, and then you'd have it do that. So you'd have to have another if function, basically.
Do you get what I'm asking, though? Like,
yeah. So it's going to change for here. So
if classic, standard, right, classic. Whatever,
right. Because basically, you can't just have it the way you have it right now, hard-coded into HTML, because it's not taking any input from the user. If you're gonna make it take any input from the user and then change afterwards, then it would have to be in the actual code at the bottom. So scroll down. I'll show you. Scroll down a little bit. All right, scroll down. Keep going. All right, scroll up. Scroll up. Yeah, you see at the top. No, keep going up. All right, you see where it says script?
Mm-hmm.
Everything from script downwards is JavaScript, and everything on top is HTML. HTML is just hard coded. The bottom part is where you're gonna start, where you'll start adding all your these other codes,
tips and whatever
functions. Whatever.
And
yeah, exactly.
Okay. So this thing is JavaScript.
Yeah. Well, some of it is, some of it isn't. So your design, your property size, everything else is just HTML, and then it changes. The changes based on input is hard coded at the bottom.
So here, this would be HTML, and then this would be JavaScript.
The bottom. I don't know. Your screen just went off. I don't know what the hell happened. No, it's not you. It's me. On yeah, there it is. Okay, it's back. What were you showing me?
So here, when I have this, like, here are some. This would be HTML, and then the sum would be JavaScript.
Right. Here are some. Yeah. Basically. Yeah. Exactly. So one part of it would be. So you see how it says span ID interior style. So now you want the interior style. So here are some whatever interior design ideas. That's fine. So now interior style itself, you'd have to add, and so interior style is fine, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's span ID whatever. Now if you go down, scroll down, you see how we have. Keep going down. Yeah. You see how we have document get whatever.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to have one for interior style, which you already do. Document whatever interior style output. What is this, the one you added?
No, this is the one you made for this part.
Oh, so you're gonna have to change the name then.
Oh,
so you would have to be
ideas.
Okay,
your ideas.
Wait, scroll up. Just scroll down. No, that's too much. No, keep going down. Yeah, you see script? Okay, go up. Okay, you see where it says const property size equals whatever. So const design ideas or whatever would equal document.element whatever, and then in the brackets. So you have to define that as well. That's my point.
Okay. Alright.
Yeah, so that's gonna be a little more. I'm probably not explaining it as well as I could, but yeah, I mean, I'll use ChatGPT. So just go back and then be like, okay, can you create me the JavaScript version for this or whatever, like JavaScript code for this.
All right.
So
can you try
my
Mac Google
now?
This?
Yeah.
Look, it's a 2. It's a random 2.
Yeah, I'll get it. Don't worry about that. Okay. Open mail.
Kid?
That's pretty dope, dude. But now I need to get rid of the redirect again. So I don't know how this. But you see the point, right? I mean, they can add any custom email directly to the email itself. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. They can just like, oh, okay. I'll just write.
And then you give the email a name because they'll be emailing you.
But is this good practice for, what do you call it? Lead magnets? Like, do you think it won't be scammy looking or spammy that is taking them to their email client? Or would they rather just click submit and it says, yes, your thing has been submitted?
You could do that, but you'd have to do it through whatever is posting your website, I think.
What do you... I get what you're saying.
But
I mean, do you do this, for example?
I feel like nothing is wrong with the way, you know, we have it right now.
Like, if you were on a website and it popped up your email to...
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, they're actually doing the writing for me and everything else, it's like...
Yeah, and once I launch it, we'll know for sure. Huh? If no one's sending emails, then I know there's something wrong, right? That'll be the ultimate variable.
You're literally looking at it. You're sending an email to someone with a title and a subject on your mail app, so it's like as safe as it gets.
Mm. Right? It doesn't say the two, though. Did you get rid of that?
Yeah, I didn't add that yet. Because I don't want to send... I didn't want to click submit and start sending stuff.
Oh, it's going to submit it straight away.
Yeah, I thought that was going to happen. But yeah, it's... Yeah. But okay. Anyway, you see the point, right? I mean, yeah. You have... Well, try to do it again and change the square feet and stuff. And also, I don't know why it keeps redirecting the way it is. Like, you see this not found crap? I don't know why that keeps...
Yeah, I should ideally just stay here in case they want to change something. I really did always, man. Come on. Whoa, just square feet. Cool.
It worked?
Yep.
Alright, solid. So do you prefer this or the forms that we had earlier?
I don't know. I don't know which one is better.
What?
I still need their name.
Yeah, I mean, there's... Oh, yeah, you're right.
They still gotta add their name. Okay, you solved a lot of the issues, man. Chunk by chunk. I'm out here just trying to get this link thing to your idea.
I don't know, dude. I want to go back to how we had it earlier, actually.
Why?
Because I feel like just the submit thing, the button just saying, you know, submit whatever, could be a bit intimidating, right? As opposed to like having a section where they can add.
Actually, yeah. And they'll be like, oh my god, this guy thinks I'm going to pay 100k already.
Submit and then $20,000.
Yeah, you'd be surprised how these little tiny things affect. That's why I was telling you to make that thing bigger last time, like the total cost. Because I'd send out this email. Here, let me show you. I'd send out an email that looked like. Wait, actually, no. I can't show you the email. But I'd send the whole quotation in an email. And then they'd reply backwards, how much does it cost? I was like, what? And then I had to highlight it and make it bold and huge so they'd never miss it out.
Do you want to send me an example of this feature on another website or a client's website? Not a client's, competitor's website.
What? Oh, yeah, sure.
It's interactive.
Yeah, ours is better though.
Is it?
I think so. Like in terms of the what do you call it? The marketing angle, I think it's better. But here, yeah, it looks more interactive. There's a lot of features. I don't need this. It's customizable, but it's all
how
you
way too, yeah.
Yeah, it's just like.
But I love the way the total changes with the slider.
Oh yeah, that's pretty cool. And I like their font type for budget calculator.
So where's the section where you can click?
At the bottom.
Submit inquiry.
At the bottom, that blue bar.
Where is that?
After you chose everything. Oh, there is no.
Uh-huh.
See, they're done.
Yeah, there are one.
Wow, they're missing out.
You know, you can just steal this code.
Are you serious? Is it by inspecting?
Yeah, inspect it, and that's it.
Go.
But yeah. I don't have Firefox or whatever the fuck.
It works on any browser, right? Oh my god. That's hilarious. It's right here.
That's funny.
Hey, let's try it. How do I copy this? Oh, you can't copy it.
Yeah, you can.
I mean, all of it. Why can't I select all of it?
Did you try Control A?
Oh, you can see all their files.
That's interesting.
Oh, what? Oh, there it is.
Obviously, you're gonna have to change some of the custom code that is only relevant for the, to their links and websites. Actually, you know what? I genuinely prefer ours.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm telling you. And that's the one that shows up first result on Google. Look at this. This is my article, bro. It's number 3. And it's just an article, and these are calculators. So, Luke, check this out. I wanted to show you.
That's as niche as it gets.
Huh?
Interior design price calculator Malaysia.
What'd you say?
So that's as niche as it gets.
Yeah.
You know, I wonder how many impressions this keyword has, or at least not this search, but interior design Malaysia. Probably not
the
that
SEO
much.
Difficulty, not that hard. Yeah, but this is where all the leads come from. Ironically. See, there's the keyword. But look, basically this is what I want to show you. This is what's ranking here. Like it's me. And then I'm like, skip to the bottom to calculate price.
Oh, actually, yeah, I wanted to show you something. Go to the main website.
Look, this is what it looks like right now, right?
Yeah,
so I could put the app right here, too. So it'll be super SEO. What was your question?
Go back on the website.
Oh, okay.
No, the main website, click home.
What do you want to
home,
see?
Home, with this book.
Oh, home?
Yeah. Okay, scroll down. Two things that I wanted to point out earlier. So, scroll down a bit. All right, stop there. So you see how all the three paragraphs at the top have a period? The third one doesn't? Can you add a period there, bro?
Oh my god, you're messing with my head right now.
Can you actually do that? And then after that's done, if you scroll down, keep scrolling down.
Period there.
No, scroll down, I'll show you the other one. Scroll down. Okay, stop, go up, again. All right, stop there, hold on. No, scroll down.
Better be not be some grammar stuff.
Yeah, there it is. Yeah, how to build luxury property that will last. See where it says, if you want the best for your future, then there's no cutting corners when it comes to building your dream home. Having whatever, all the way to the bottom where it says, if you're in real estate property. Can we get rid of that shit and fix it?
When did you see this?
This morning.
Wow, this guy. My whole website.
Yep. Just the front page.
Hey, look at this.
And there was one other thing that I spotted that was off. Yeah, I saw that picture, dude. Top G.
He's in the middle, bro.
It's so funny how the one on your left is just staring at you too.
Yeah, that's pretty funny.
I thought you were the boss for a second. I was like, why is it a goober design? Right.
Look, this is the other calculator, number two. Sucks.
Oh,
Look, they're all copying me, bro. I swear to God, I did this. I was the first one that did this. Bastard.
What? Ours hasn't even launched yet.
No, the article, man. I'm the first one to come up with this term.
Oh, let's see. And these are just too complicated, man.
Dude, like, imagine the guy who coded this. How much work?
Yeah. Like, and God, it actually worked too.
They were out here doing it one day.
That's
look,
legit.
All this is to get that. Oh, look, get your report
your
sent.
Your name?
But what would I email? Value in that? Why would I want the report sent to me? Like, what are you gonna just repeat what I just clicked?
Your estimated budget, just that? That's all that gets said?
Yeah, I mean, all he's gonna say in the report is like, your property, things you selected, get your report sent to you.
But you see how they don't have a custom inquiry tab?
Yeah, they don't. So the first one had no submit, but the second one was too complicated and no custom inquiry. Let's see these
guys.
Oh
man. That's some legit fucking programming there, bro. Whoever made that, like, the one we just saw?
This one?
It's crazy. Man.
Yeah.
Wait, can you inspect that? I want to see if it's JavaScript too. Oh, it is. Wow. JavaScript. Script at the bottom. Whoa. All the code? No, it can't be. That's the entire code? No, there it is.
see it. Oh, this guy's blocking me. He's smart.
Whoa. Whoa.
Hey, look what they added to the pictures.
This guy is so organized. We have everything in one tap.
Alright. This is the third one.
This is horrible.
This one is hurts my head, man. What the hell is going on?
Yeah, this was horrible.
This is like a Google spreadsheet problem.
You can admit this one in ChatGPT in 2 seconds.
This is like some Google sheet. Look.
Send me this.
You want to see this? See, request for consultation.
Yeah, I just put bottom code for it.
This one's good. You can request for consultation. I guess maybe you should do something like this.
Yeah. So that's why. So send me this one. I'll copy the code at the bottom. Class. Bass.
Class.
Alright. Be helpful. Oh, I can't inspect.
Really?
Let me download the box. Boomba Cloud. What browser do you use?
Brave. Only for the real G's. Brave browser.
I wonder how you make this inspect stuff private.
Can you even?
I hope so.
Yeah, I think just ChatGPT is better.
This requires me to actually understand what the hell's going on with Echo.
It's only those who are really vitally serious can live properly. Can live a life that's complete and whole. And that seriousness doesn't exclude joy. Enjoy. But as long as there is fear, one cannot possibly be serious or enjoy or know what it means to have great joy. One of the most common things in life. And strangely, we have accepted as a way of life, as we have accepted violence in all its various forms, as a way of life, we have also accepted and have got used to being psychologically as well as physically afraid. And this evening, if we can, we should go into this question. We should, I feel, go into it so completely. We shall be rid of this fear. I think it can be done. Thank you.
Uber.
Yeah.
Any progress?
Not really.
What?
No progress, sir. No progress. No progress. Hey, no progress. Whoa. No progress. No progress.
Where is going on?
It got rid of my button.
Uber Studios. Uber Studios. And now, all the way from where are you again?
Where am I from?
LA. Oh, it was probably
LA.
and ask him.
To San Jose, we have the one and only Brute Famous Goober Studio.
Did you send me a code? Wait, where's my original one?
Oh, yeah, look at this lady in the chat. Hi.
Yeah.
Yeah, the code I sent you is for the first one that I tried to steal from the other people.
Goober Studio.
Gabber. It's Yam Gabber, bro. This is Goober Studios.
You ain't yammering. Gabber.
Hey, this is just yammering away. Gabbering all day.
Alright, so.
Come on, bro. Blast me off, 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 bro. I'm losing it right now. I'm losing it. He's gonna be gapping. He's gonna be
I love this fucking thing.
Several of them are dead now. Others are doing
ChatGPT?
Oh, yeah.
There are no more junkies at 103rd Broadway waiting for the connection.
Hey, did your friend like that house mix I sent him?
The what?
The house mix.
What's it again?
The house music.
What about it? Oh, no one said anything about it.
Oh, okay. So he didn't become a PUBG. He didn't become a PUBG. He's a PUBG to his friends.
Whoa, this works? Dude, if this works, I'm gonna lose my shit. Scrub G or top G, bro?
Only top, always top. I ain't a mangolini.
Hey. Calculate.
Come on, GPT. Come on, GPT. Enjoying these tunes, man? Come on. Give me a heads up. Give me a thumbs up for DJ Google Studios. Live streaming coded. Oh, we got eight viewers. Give me a thumbs up in the chat if you're liking these tunes, man. You. What up?
Good.
Check out my guy here, Ben Svensson. Miss Svensson. who's been streaming for more than 1 hour. Miss Benson.
Whoa.
Oh, my juice is a flow. GPT, are you done? GPT, you can monitor.
I think I figured it out, dude.
Did you?
I think I figured it out.
Dude, I'm so high right now from all this. I took a cold shower. My body's like buzzing.
Did you actually take a cold shower? She don't see her. Oh, I know what the problem is. Oh, it was a fucking problem. You see now?
Yeah.
So, problem now is I added it, so you can add like whatever you want. Like, yeah, you can, you know, but look at this. Shows it there, right? And then, whoop, it gets deleted.
Wait, what?
Let's say it's all already populated, I can populate it.
Why is
then
it twice?
As soon as someone's put it, it deletes. What?
Why do you have custom party twice?
Oh, don't worry about it. I'm just showing you that. I'm testing two different ones.
Okay, show me again.
I test multiple at a time because I'm a top G.
Show me again.
That's top G. So basically, the second one, I managed to get things to auto-populate in there. So look. See, it's already there. I can make it anything. I can make it the value of custom, whatever, right? But It shows as soon as the user starts typing anything, it just disappears.
That's weird. So,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
But if they submit without doing anything, then you get the gray stuff. But if they type, they're basically overriding it. Mm-hmm. Which is... tells you that this is the problem from another day. It's 11.
Is it 11 already?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I give up. This was, yes, if this was Friday, honestly, I'd stay up till 7 a.m. to try to work on this, but try to figure it out. But I have an early day tomorrow. Actually, I have a job. Unfortunately.
Oh, this guy flexing on his job. All right.
Job.
All right. Mangolini. God, job. Deals with mangoes.
Are you working tomorrow?
Yeah.
Oh, look at this guy with fucking job. This guy was just... God, we got it, bro. You gotta wake up for work tomorrow.
Oh, God, man. I can't believe we spent 3 hours on this and we made zero progress.
Look, this is what I spent 3 hours on, okay?
Let's see.
Spent 3 hours doing this thing. Is it click minimal? Calculate.
Wait, why? What happened to the other one?
It's over here. I just wanted to break down the code to this only so I can give it to GPT. And it gave me this, which looked like it made a lot of good sense. But then when I pasted it here, I think it clashed with some of the other shit I did, and it gave me this stuff.
It shouldn't clash.
Because it's supposed to paste out this link. And I'm sure it would clash because of this thing. It didn't ask me to put this. Actually, no, I gave it that. Look, I gave it this thing. I'm like, here, get this, paste, spit out this thing when someone chooses minimal from this. I gave it this whole thing, and then it gave me this. So I pasted it here.
Well, you asked him to spit it out, so he's spat around.
Yeah, but that's what I spent 3 hours on, so.
No, it shouldn't be like that. One shouldn't be that complicated, because you just basically look at the top and see how we defined the other functions to get it to split to spit out something based on the user's input, and just copy and paste that exact same thing and just change the wordings and then change the output. You don't even need ChatGPT for that.
No, it didn't.
Whoa,
work.
Whoa, dude, did you figure that out?
No, I couldn't figure it out. I tried following it from here, but it was all different formats. I mean, look at this. Look at that.
I can't see it. You can't tell.
Oh,
no, you're not showing.
Yeah, anymore. Okay. Yeah. Oh, well.
Yeah. Well, right. Anyway, we tried. Then. Are you going to keep working?
I got nothing else to do, so probably.
All right, cool. Yeah, so just if you can finish that part today, and then hopefully tomorrow we get this email thing sorted, and then we can just then start working on like visuals, last touch ups and stuff like that.
Yeah,
and should be good to go.
All right, Mr. Mango.
So yes, I can. Excuse me. We can talk about the rest offline. I wanted to ask you about yeah, anyway, we'll talk about that afterwards.
All right, cool.
Ciao.
Please.
Bye.
The book. Thank you.
anybody know what to do here? Help me. I know the answer is here. Yep. All right, guys. Ow. Just gonna end it here. Can't figure this out right now.
Yeah, I'm good.
Feel like I've done a lot today, even though I solved almost nothing. But so it happens. I don't understand what the hell he's doing. But yeah. Anyways, 1% is better than 0%. Well, let's end it here right now. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you guys had a good productive study session. Okay? And I'll catch you on the next one. This is Cooper Studios. You know I'll be back. And you've seen the development as this app over the past 4 videos. So, you know how it is here. We document the journey because the journey to mastery is a process, not a means to an end. And I'll end it with that. Goodbye. Goodbye, everybody. What a woman.